Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we have a topic to discuss, which is income statement. Let's understand this. See, this is the vital thing for any investor to understand what exactly is income statement, because that's where the whole financial position. So basically what exactly the company has made, the profits can be really determined. The income statement is one of the most important financial statement, you can say that. It's a fin statement, and investors need to look at if they want to invest into any company. So the primary purpose of looking at any income statement of the company is to ensure that, you know, you get the whole picture. You get the whole picture of the company's income and expenses during the year. Consolidated statement of operation of boxing, as you can see. What exactly, you know, we note that the boxing has been making losses for the past 3 years. As you can see, the numbers over here in yellow. So what does this tell us about the company? Its business model, its revenue generation capacity, its control and cost. Well, here we are. See, in this tutorial, we understand, you know, income statement is the most important financial statement for the financial analyst. Now, first, what is the income statement? See, income statement definition. The basic purpose of looking at the income statement of the company is to ensure that, you know, you get the whole picture. You get the whole picture of the company's income and expenses. During the year, I'm going to show you over here. This is Colgate's Palmolive Company's consolidated statement of income. Now, this is a snapshot of what an income statement format is all about. It should be, actually. So first, an income statement is basically a statement which shows us how much the revenue. It shows us, you know, how much the revenue a company has earned over the past year. So revenue over here means that, you know, the total sales over the period. Total sales over the period, and total sales is equal to units into price per unit. So Colgate's revenue in 2015 was 16,034. That was 16,034 million. And income statement format, you know, it always shows you the cost in the expenses that has been incurred during the year. So this cost can directly or indirectly affect the revenue of the company. Let's see what is the cost of sales for 2015. Well, the cost of sales is 6635. 6635 million in 2015. That means comparing the revenue and the cost, an income statement provides you a comparative analysis. Comparative analysis of an income statement. Basically, comparing the income statement provides you a comparative analysis of what mattered for a company during the year, how much the profit, that is net profit, they have earned, if any, or how much net loss they have incurred, and the net income of the Colgate of 2015, which was the net income of the Colgate that showed at 1384 over here. The number is right visible to us. Right, so an income statement format is also portrays the EPS, that is the earning per share of the company during the same period. So the calculation is based on the assumption that if the net earnings are also distributed among the shareholders, how much each shares would get priced. And usually the firm never distributes all the earnings. So major portions reinvested. You can say, you know, there's a plowing back of profit. So Colgate's basic earning per share, BEPS, was 1.53 per share. And according to the SEC, that is a Security Exchange Commission, think of income statement as a set of stairs. The idea is to look at, you know, the revenue and the cost one by one. So first we will look at the revenue and then the cost directly or indirectly affecting the sale. So and then we will take the stairs and take interest and taxes into account, which will ultimately provide us with the net profit or loss. So finally, remember that, you know, the ultimate net profit or net loss is called the bottom line and it is how much a company earned and lost during the accumulated period. And as an investor, you should also start from the top, that is the revenue part, and come towards the bottom, that is the net profit part or the net loss. Now I'm going to show you the income statement format, how it does exactly it works. See, as a financial analyst, you know, we should look at the income statement format very carefully. The primary objective of analyzing income statement is to understand how the business is generating recurring revenues in contrast to its expense and whether the business is profitable or not. Now, this is the income statement format. There's a revenue from the sales of goods, operating expenses, that gives you operating from continuing operations. This is the key to the continuing operations. Then there are recurring income like interest and taxes and finance costs. So that gives you your recurring pre-tax income from continuing. Any unusual or non-recurring items, pre-tax earning from the continuing operations, any sort of income tax expenses that you incur, and then you get the net income. Then you have post facto, the discounted operations, income from the discontinued operation, not discounted, discontinued operations, any extraordinary items, and the cumulative effect of the change. Finally, you get the net income from the above. So over here, this is the analysis. Analysts need not worry about this item below this one, because those are some of the extraordinary items and discontinued operation that they usually do not take into consideration. Now, the sales and the revenue. At the top of the income statement, an accountant has to write the total money that has been brought, the total money that has been brought into the account, the company by the sales, and it includes the total sales revenue also. It includes the total sales revenue, and the total sales can be generated via, you know, selling the product or services, right? So it is also called as the gross revenue. Gross means, you know, it has not been refined. Gross means it has not been refined. And in this case, gross means, you know, the expenses are yet to get deducted. The next line would be, you know, the unexpected item, which company never expected while making the sales. And it can be like, you know, the sales return or sales discount. So in the next line, the sales return or sales discount will be deducted, which will provide us with our net revenue part. And that means this is the actual revenue the company has earned after taking sales return or sales discount into account. Well, this were a couple of details in relation to income statement. But the basic ones that one should know it as an analyst, as an investor, so as to be really well versed with the data. In the final analysis, I would say that, you know, the income statement is one of the most important financial statement investors should look at before they make a decision to invest into the company. And if you want to invest in a company, you can use the vertical and horizontal analysis of the income statement to make informed decisions.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.